Hey loves, welcome back to my chat. Now, I know you guys thought we're about to see a Nigerian movie with that intro music, but girl, I'm about to slay a bubble ponytail. So right now, my hair is freshly washed. I literally just washed my hair like an hour before this video. So my hair is kind of like damp, so it's still, you know, wet and soft and, you know, all that good fun stuff. So the first thing I went ahead to do is to use my Cantu leave-in conditioner just to give my hair some extra moisture and also to, you know, soften my hair a lot more just so it's a lot easier to manipulate. And then as per usual, I went next with my Jamaican black castor oil to moisturize my scalp, make sure that my hair is juicy before we actually, you know, style this hair into a ponytail. So for this ponytail, I wanted like a spicy look. I wanted to add some extra glam to the front of the hair. Parted out this first little section of hair in front that I'm actually going to be using to do like the rubber band crisscross style. So after parting that, I just wanted to make sure that everything is out of the way. Then I held the rest of my hair using my butterfly clamps. As you guys can see, my parting is not that straight, but it's gonna be covered, so you know, no one is going to see that part. And then I also went ahead again to use my Jamaican black castor oil to make sure my scalp is moisturized because we're in winter, so I always have to make sure that my scalp is juicy all the time. Starting off with this style that I'm going to be doing in front, this section of my hair that I parted in front, I'll be parting that into three. And then for each section of the one third, that's each one third section of this entire front, I'll be parting it into four. I don't know if that makes sense. But you guys would definitely understand what I'm saying as we keep going forward. So I'm definitely going to end up with the entire, you know, I'm going to be doing four. So four ponytails per one third section of this front hair. So at the end of the day, I'm going to end up with 12 natural hair ponytails in front. Hold down my ponytail, I'll be using the Style Factor Edge Booster Gel as per usual. And I'll just grab some, just a little bit. You don't need too much. Put some on your fingers and just rub that through your natural hair. It just helps to bind your natural hair together. So when you actually put it in the ponytail, it ends up being neat and nice. And for this rubber band part of this video, I'm going to make sure that I put some oil on my rubber band just so the rubber band is more pliable and it's easy for it to come off when it's time to take it down without breaking your natural hair. After which, I just went ahead to, you know, give my natural hair a little stretch just to make sure that the rubber band sits nice and good. Okay, I'm just going to repeat this process again. So grab my natural hair, apply some of your gel. You can use any gel that you have. You can use the Style Factor, you could use Eco Styler gel, basically any gel that you feel that works for you. After applying the gel, then I use my edge brush to brush my natural hair just so everything is neat, so everything just stays laid and nice and neat. And then I went ahead to use my oiled rubber band to actually put my natural hair into a little ponytail. And then I'll just stretch my natural hair, give it a little stretch on both ends just to make sure that the rubber band actually stays, you know, tight and sealed properly to my hair. If your hair gets dry along the way, feel free to spray some water like you guys see me doing in between, like when my hair feels dry and a little hard. I normally go ahead to spray some water while styling it. In that way, it's just going to allow you to be more, you know, a lot easier to manipulate, a lot softer. I'll just leave you guys to watch just so you guys can actually follow while I do the exact same little natural hair ponytails for like my entire front of this hair. When I get to the front, I always like to make sure that my partings are symmetrical. That's why you guys see me, you know, using my eyebrow as a landmark to actually make sure that the lines are equal on both sides. Of course, half the time it's never equal though, but you know, it just gives it more of a symmetrical look when you actually make sure that the patterns are even on both sides of your head. You have a pretty fine girl and I have a pretty fine wristana. Then I'm basically done with my 12 natural hair ponytails. Like you guys can see, I'm going to go ahead right now to start crisscrossing it. So I'll be crossing like diagonal diagonal on opposite ends. So like I'll grab the one on the right, I'll cross it towards the next one on the left. But before I go ahead to crisscross this, I'll just apply some gel just so my natural hair stays together and it's like, you know, it's sealed, it's not going to be, you know, fluffy out, so everything actually stays sleek. I'll put some gel, then swirl it, kind of like you're twisting it, but you're not twisting it, it's more like you're just swirling it and then crisscross it. You could also twist your natural hair if you feel like if you swirl it, it's not gonna hold together, or if you feel like you can't even swirl it, just feel free to twist it as well. You'll basically still get the exact same result. So swirl it and then crisscross to the next one and then go ahead again to use the exact same elastic band that I've been using. Put that on and just pull it just to make sure everything stays, you know, tight and stays properly and it's not moving. Also, don't forget to make sure that your elastic bands are oiled. So there's oil, it's grease, it makes it a lot easier to take it down when it's time to actually take down this hairstyle. It's just so easy to just, you know, it gives it that very smooth gliding when you're actually taking it off from your hair. Now that we're done with the crisscrossing, like you guys can see, I'm just going to go back to the rest of my natural hair that's at the back. Spray some water because right now it's dry and I just need some water just so I can be able to, you know, work my hands through this. And then I'll go back again using my Style Factor Edge Booster Gel and then apply this gel and put the rest of my natural hair in a high bun. And I'll be using my bristle brush to brush everything, make sure it's smooth and nice and laid and just hold everything. And I use this this huge elastic headband. I use it to hold my natural hair into a bun very nice and good. And remember, if your hair is a lot thicker than mine, you would need to work your hair in sections. So if you're applying gel, you have to actually put the gel in small sections into this bun. For me, my hair is not that thick, but I also still had to work my hair in sections. So I applied the gel in between, inside, not just on the surface. You actually have to put the gel inside and then comb everything together just so your gel is not poofy. Nothing, you know, so it's not poofy. Everything just stays slick together. So you have to actually apply the gel inside, not just on the surface. Apply it inside and then brush and comb. Make sure everything is smooth. Everything is together, you know, it's detangled and nice, okay? So in that way, your hair is actually going to stay sleek. It's going to stay together, if that makes sense. Also have a couple detailed hair tutorials on my channel on how to, you know, sleek down your natural hair step by step. So you could also check that one out too if this wasn't really detailed enough. So right now I went ahead to twist the end of my natural hair to one single ponytail. And then I went ahead to use the satin head wrap from Red by Kiss. I just held my hair together down and nice. And I basically went to bed. So this is the following morning. This is my hair right now. Everything is dry, like you guys can see. I'm just going to go ahead to fold my natural hair ponytail into a bun so we can move over to installing the bubble ponytail. So for this bubble ponytail, I wanted something that actually looks like my natural hair in terms of texture. So I used the Marley hair. It's called the Soft Reggae Braids. This is color 1B. So I opened this hair and I realized that, damn, this might be too short for actually what I had imagined. So I was like, wait a minute, like how can I actually make this style to be a lot longer? So I, you know, figured it out and I was like, okay, yes, I got this. But I ended up using 1.5 pack of extensions, which wasn't the initial plan. I was just like, oh my God, thank God I actually bought 2 packs of hair. Like you guys can see, I went to grab the second pack. So I grabbed half from this one. That's that whole bunch from there. Mm-hmm. And then I used the other one that you guys saw me open the first time. I used all of that. So I ended up using 1.5 pack of extension. So I grabbed the hair extension and my elastic band, made it into a door handle on this extension. But I made sure that I did this towards the end of the extension. So not in the middle, towards the end, just so I could be able to get more length for this extension. I wanted my bubble ponytail to be long. I wanted it to go all the way down to my booty. And then this little short section of this Marley hair, I went ahead to twist it nicely all the way to the end. And then I used it to hold down this extension onto my natural hair. So that actually helped to give my ponytail a lot more security so it actually doesn't move at all. And then I wrapped this little twist that we just did, the short one, all around. I didn't need to use any bobby pins. I just wrapped it and folded it and tucked it into the, you know, the wrap. But if you feel like you have to use bobby pins, please feel free to use bobby pins because you want to make sure that your ponytail is secure. You don't want your ponytail falling down in public, right? So you want to make sure that your ponytail is secure. And also to give you that more natural look and more blended, seamless look, I grabbed some of the extra Marley hair from the entire ponytail and I used that again to wrap all over the very first short one that we wrapped. So I gave it like a second wrap around, wrapped it, and I was like, wow, okay, this looks like it's going to be it's going to be coming out looking pretty good, because I didn't know what to do, to be quite honest, you guys. When I got to this point and I saw my hair in the mirror, I was like, yes, I think we're making progress over here. Going back to using this little oiled rubber band, I'll go ahead to put this onto this ponytail. So kind of make like balloons, bubbles with this elastic band. So like step by step, put it in sections. And while putting it, just make sure that you're puffing your extensions, just so it gives you that fluffy balloon look, that bubble look, because that's what we're going for, right? So make sure you're fluffing your hair while you're actually putting this elastic band. One thing I actually made sure I was looking for when I went to the beauty supply store was a Marley hair that was soft in texture and fluffy. I didn't want something that was too, you know, some of these Marley hair, some of them are very, very dry and stiff. But I wanted something that was soft because they are actually easier to manipulate when it's soft. And it's also easier to fluff it when the hair is soft. So if you want to get like a fluffy ponytail, like a fluffy balloon ponytail like this, when you go to the beauty supply store, just try to make sure that you're looking for a Marley extension that's soft. And it's also fluffy in texture. So like the Janet collection is a good one. Shake and Go, I think that's what's called. I always see that at the beauty supply store. It's also a good one. And this one that I got is also really good. So when I basically got to the end of this, you know, ponytail, and when I was done putting the little elastic bands, I just twisted the rest of the ends of the ponytail. And this was basically all I did for this hair, you guys. And the last thing I went ahead to do was to accessorize my hair. So I accessorized the ponytail and also went ahead to accessorize the crisscross part of this video. And that's basically it for this video, you guys. Can you guys look at this ponytail? We didn't know what we were doing, but we got here, and I really love the end result of this look. I rocked this hair for a good 1 week. I should have carried it longer, but I got bored of the hairstyle. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, please don't forget to give me a big thumbs up, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. I love you guys so much. Have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Bye. The things that nobody can. I'ma make you bounce like a hurricane. I'ma make your bed rock like a hurricane. I'ma do it like nobody can. And I'll give you all the things that nobody can. Standard. Hurricane.